This is an example problem where you're shown how to find the equivalent capacitance of a group of capacitors where some of the capacitors are in series and some of them are in parallel with each other. Okay, so the goal is to find the equivalent capacitance of the three capacitors in the diagram shown there on the screen. Okay, now, what we want to do is first, we need to figure out which of these capacitors are in series with each other and which are in parallel. Because the goal is we should take two capacitors at a time and combine them two at a time. But which two should we start with? We could start with one and two. We could start with one and three. We could start with two and three. So how do you decide which two to start with? Well, let's first check and see if any of the capacitors are in series with one another. So if you look at the definition of series, it says one plate of the first capacitor is connected to the second capacitor, and only one plate. So if you look at capacitor C1 and C2, you see that the rightmost plate of C1 is connected to the leftmost plate of C2. And that's the only plate that's connected between C1 and C2. The other sides are not connected to each other. Furthermore, we see that there are not any junctions or anything else in between C1 and C2. So evidently, C1 and C2 are in series with each other. We can go ahead and start by combining those two. Now, before I do that, I want to show you why we can't start with C1 and C3 or C2 and C3. Okay, are C2 and C3 in series with each other? At first you might think yes, because if you follow the red line, you see, one plate of C2 is connected to one plate of C3. But look, we have a junction there, so it doesn't satisfy the second requirement for being in series. Okay, and the same thing happens for C1. It's not in series with C3 either because of this junction over here. All right, so what we have to do then is we'll start with C1 and C2. And let's clear these other things. Okay? None of the capacitors are in parallel with one another either. Okay, so we'll start with C1 and C2. They are in series with each other, which means we need to use this equation. Okay. Both of those equations under the series are mathematically identical. I prefer the lower one because I find often that students forget to take the reciprocal at the end if you use the upper form of that equation. So I'm going to use the lower form. Okay. So to find the equivalent capacitance of C1 and C2, I'm going to call that C12. And we'll say that that's equal to 1 over C1 plus 1 over C2. That is equal to 1 over C1 is 6 nanofarads, and C2 is 3 nanofarads. Okay, so we now have C12 is equal to 1 over, I need to find a common denominator for a sixth and a third, so 1/6 will work. I have 1/6 nanofarads plus 2/6 nanofarads, because 1/3 is the same as 2/6. 1/6 plus 2/6 is 3/6. 1/3/6 is the same thing as 6/3. And 6/3 is just 2. So the equivalent capacitance of capacitors 1 and 2 is 2 nanofarads. Okay, I'm going to clear some of the work that we just did to get it out of the way. So you want to pause now if you need some more time to write this down. Okay, so we've found that the equivalent capacitance for C1 and C2, which we're calling C12, is 2 nanofarads. So we'll write that up at the top of the screen. Now, once you've found that, what you do is you redraw your diagram and you replace C1 and 2 with the new equivalent capacitance. So let's redraw our picture, except here where I had C1 and C2 separate before, I'm going to put C12 there, a single capacitor that represents the combination of C1 and C2 that we just found, 2 nanofarads. Okay, and then we still have C3 down here because we haven't done anything with it yet. Okay, now we need to decide if C12 and C3 are in series or in parallel with each other. And it turns out they're in parallel with each other because a wire is an equipotential line or an equipotential surface. So this plate of C12 is connected to one plate, C13. They're at the same potential. And then the other side of C12 is at the same potential as the other side of C13. So that meets the definition for two capacitors being in parallel, which means that I can now combine C12 with C3. Let's call that C123. So the equivalent capacitance for two capacitors in parallel is just the sum of the two capacitances. So we'll have C12 plus C3. C123 is then equal to the 2 nanofarads that we found before, plus 7 nanofarads of C3. So the equivalent capacitance of that whole thing is simply 9 nanofarads. Now, this example I did, we had only 3 capacitors. But you can use this method of doing capacitors 2 at a time, even for a huge number of capacitors. You know, even if you have 8 or 10 capacitors in your circuit, you can work it the same way. You start with one pair of capacitors at a time. And as soon as you simplify that pair of capacitors, you replace it in the circuit with a single capacitor with its equivalent capacitance, and you move on to another pair of capacitors until finally you end up with a single capacitor, which in our case has a capacitance of C123 or 9 nanofarads.